Welcome to Prudence Coaching. Here you will get ICSE and WBPSC English Solution by Sudipta sir. Besides, you will get the best coaching for ICSE and ISC computer application with BlueJay by Mamita ma'am. So subscribe our channel now to get the latest updates and stay connected and press the bell icon on the YouTube app. Topic of the day. Today we will discuss about ICSE English Language Expected Question Paper 2020. Before beginning the question paper, we will discuss about the marks division in ICSE English Language Paper. In internal assessment, you will have 20 marks and in ICSE Language Paper, you will have 80 marks. So the total marks in ICSE Language Paper is 100. Now we will discuss about ICSE English Language Paper. Here the full marks is 80 and ICSE English Language Paper is also known as English Paper 1. The given time limit is 2 hours. Here are some important notes that you need to know, and these notes will also be written at the top of your question paper as it is written here. Answers to this paper must be written on the paper provided separately. So the answer sheet will be supplied to you by the board. You will not be allowed to write during the first 15 minutes. This time is to spend in reading the question paper. The question paper will be handed over to you before the beginning of the exam and it will be given to you before 15 minutes. In this time, you will need to read the question paper carefully. The time given at the head of this paper is the time allowed for writing the answers. So, for writing your answer, you will get 2 hours. And 15 minutes you are getting for reading the question paper. So let's start the questions. Attempt all 5 questions. In your question paper there will be 5 questions, like question 1, question 2, question 3, question 4 and question 5. You need to answer all the 5 questions. The intended marks for the questions or the parts of questions are given in brackets. The marks for the given questions will be provided within brackets. Here are some important guidelines given by the board. So it is advised to you that you should not spend more than 30 minutes in answering question 1 and 20 minutes in answering question 2. So question 1 is about composition writing. So here you must not spend more than 30 minutes. And question 2 is about letter writing. So here you must not spend 20 minutes. Because if you spend more than 30 minutes or 20 minutes, then you will not be able to complete your question paper. So finally, we are going to start our question paper. Let's start. Question 1. Do not spend more than 30 minutes on this question. So you should complete your answer of question 1 within 30 minutes. Write a composition about 300 to 350 words on any one of the following. Here you will get 5 topics, and for writing a single composition you will get 20 marks. You should maintain the word limit, which is about 300 to 350 words. Most of the students ask and concerned about this word limit as well. My advice is that you should maintain the word limit, but if your essay or composition is crossing the word limit from 400 to 410, then certainly it will attract the attention of the examiner and he or she is going to deduct your marks. So try to maintain the given word limit. Topic 1. Pride comes before a fall. Write an original story that brings out the truth of this statement. So if you choose topic 1, then you need to write a single story, but this must be contextual about the given statement. Pride comes before a fall. Number 2. Recently the chief minister of your state has visited your school as the chief guest of the annual function. Write an article for your school magazine describing his or her visit. Suppose the chief minister of your state has arrived in your school as the chief guest of the annual function. So you need to write a single piece of composition which is going to be published in your school magazine, and you should describe about the grand celebration that all of you have enjoyed in your school. Topic 3. Narrate your experience when you are left alone in the house to look after your sister. So Number third is all about the narrative composition. Here you need to write about your experience when you were alone in your house with your little sister and how you have looked after her. Fourth topic, express your views either for or against the following topic. So fourth topic is about the argumentative composition. Here the topic is computers and internet hamper the studying hours of students. It is more destructive and less helpful. So if you choose this argumentative statement, then you need to write about either for or the against of the topic. How computer and internet is harmful for the students, or how it is less helpful and how it is destroying the serious studying hours of the students. You need to elaborate the statement in your own way. As you can see, the fifth topic is about picture study or picture composition. Study the picture given below. Write a short story or a description or an account what it suggests to you. Your composition may be about the subject of the picture, or you may take suggestions from it. However, there must be a clear connection between the picture and your composition. So, you need to write a contextual composition about the given picture. You can follow the instructions or follow the description which has been mentioned in this picture. In the picture, you can see an old man is being carried by the local people on a cooking utensil, and they are trying to save the old man. So you need to write a contextual story or certain description which will describe about the flood situation and the harmful effects of the flood on the people. So try to explain the composition in your own words. Question number 2. Do not spend more than 20 minutes on this question. So you are advised not to spend more than 20 minutes for writing the answer of question number 2. This question number 2 is about letter writing. Here two letters will be given. One is formal letter and another one is informal letter. So you need to write the answer either for the formal or the informal letter, for which you are going to get 10 marks. A. Write a letter to the mayor of the municipal corporation of your city complaining about the miserable condition of the roads and insanitary condition of drainage system in your locality. So on behalf of the local people, you should write a formal letter to the mayor of the municipal corporation in your city. You should complain about the miserable condition of the roads and the problems that you are facing about there. You should also mention the suggestions and the solutions for the problem. Question number B. For the first time in your life, you have taken part in a drama in the annual program of your school. You have also overcome some of your stage fright. Fright means fear. Write a letter to your friend describing your feelings. So, second question is about an informal letter. You should describe how you have overcome your stage fear and your feelings and your performance with your friend. So you should write everything about the program and about your experiences which you have got after performing in the drama. Question number 3. Do not spend more than 10 minutes on this question. So you are advised to complete the answer for question number 3 within 10 minutes. This question number 3 is about notice or email writing. You need to write either a notice or an email, for which you are going to get 5 marks. Now, question A. As the secretary of St. Louis School, write a notice about the visit to the blind school in the neighborhood. So, as the secretary of St. Louis School, you have to write a notice to inform the principal of the blind school about your visit. And for the same topic, you need to write an email to the principal of the blind school, informing them about the visit of your school. So either you can choose a notice writing or an email writing. Best of luck. Question number 4. This question will be about comprehension writing. Here an unknown passage will be given to you and you need to write the answer after reading the passage carefully. Now the passage about happiness. Happiness, after all, is an inner state of mind. So happiness is the feeling which comes from our heart. It is little dependent on outside environment. Happiness has very little to do, for instance or example, with whether you are rich or not. So whether you are rich or not, it does not depend on the feelings of happiness. Some of the most miserable persons I have come across in my life are the rich people. So the narrator has come across or met with some of the unhappy people who are rich as well. It is true that poverty makes one miserable in a very acute way. So according to the narrator, it is the fact that happiness is also affected by poverty. But my point is that it is not wealth but coordination of one's thought and action which removes inner conflict. So according to the narrator, it is that. So wealth is not the sole thing which is controlling the happiness, but it is the coordination, means the assimilation of one's thought and action, which is the central action and removing the inner conflicts of our mind or the inner class of our mind. It is in that way that integration of one's personality is being achieved. So in that way, the coordination or the assimilation of one's personality can be gained. There are quite enough people in India who think that India is obviously the greatest country. In the days when we were politically subjected and could not take much pride in our political condition, we prided ourselves on our spiritual greatness. Having nothing else to get hold of, we took refuge in spirituality. So the narrator explained that there are few people in India who believes in the greatness of the country, and as we didn't have anything to be boast of on the political ground in the past times, we shifted our thinking on the spiritual greatness. If you go to other countries, I shall not name them as I do not wish to cause any offense or any crime, you will find the people there think that their country is the chosen country, the torch bearer of the civilization, the most advanced country, the most revolutionary country, the country with the biggest buildings, the country with something unique, some mission or other. It is natural for one to like one's own country and one's own people. So it's very common for any person to be boast of the things that he or she had in his country. He or she can think about the greatness of the country, he or she can explain his country as the torch bearer of the civilization, most advanced country, or the country with biggest buildings or something unique in his country. Or he can claim that his country is the leader of the nation and the world as well. But it's very bad for one to be overconfident about anyone's own country. It would be unnatural not to do so. It is good to be a little proud of one's own country, but it is wrong to start imagining that we are the highest and the best in the world. The fact is that every country and every people have admirable points about them. They have their achievements to their credit. They have also bad periods in their history. This applies not to countries only, but to individuals. Nobody is perfect. He has weaknesses and failings. Nobody is thoroughly bad either. We are all mixtures of good and evil, but we should try to find out the good in ourselves and in others. So according to the narrator, that it is good for one to take pride of one's own country, but it is very bad for one to think that his or her country is the best of all. And according to the narrator, it is also the fact that in this universe, nobody is perfect. A human character is a mixture of well and woe. So we should try our best to find out the good things in others. Most of you probably did not see Gandhiji as close quarters. He had amazing qualities. One of these qualities was that he managed to draw out the good in another person. The other person may have had plenty of evil in him, but he somehow spotted the good and laid emphasis on that good. So the narrator has already mentioned about some unique qualities of Gandhiji. Gandhiji was such a person who always tried to search out the good qualities within a person. It may happen that the person having a lot of evil qualities or the evil instincts in him, but Gandhiji always strengthened on his good qualities only. The result was that poor man had to try to be good. He could not help it. He would feel a little ashamed when he did something wrong. So as a result of Gandhiji's unique theory, the man who had committed crime, he would try to become good and he would feel insulted for doing something wrong. We are much too apt to look at the evil in another individuals and countries rather than the good. Perhaps some of you know the saying in the Bible about the person who could not see the beam in his own eye and saw the mote in the other's eye. I am sorry if you think I am rambling or talking incoherently, but this is, I might inform you, his secret. A very clear attempt to get behind your mind. I am at least being frank with you. So here the narrator explained that we, the humans, are very much skilled in searching out the bad things in another individuals, but we never try to find out the good qualities of that person. And here, for referring to this, he has referred to certain biblical reference of the Gospels of Matthew, where Jesus Christ, he himself argued that it is the height of hypocrisy to point out a minor flaw in another when your sins are much worse. So, by referring to this biblical reference, the narrator metaphorically insults our bad instincts of searching bad qualities within a man. Rather, we have to try to find out the best qualities of a human being. And it's also the secret of Gandhiji that he always tried to find out the good qualities and tried to emphasize on that qualities. Question number 4. After a thorough reading of the passage, you will be able to answer the following questions. Question number A. Give the meaning of the following words as used in the passage. One word answers or short phrases will be accepted. So you need to write the meaning of the following three words for which you are getting 3 marks. And for this, you will need to write the meaning according to the passage. You should not write the literal meaning of the word. Number 1 is integration, 2 is unique, number 3 is ashamed. Number B. Answer the following questions briefly in your own words. Number 1. What is the secret of genuine happiness? For this you are getting 2 marks. Number 2. Why did India take refuge in spirituality? 1 mark. What does ordinary people do in their interaction with others? 2 marks. Nobody is perfect. Elaborate and explain the expression. For 2 marks. Why does the author refer to the Holy Bible in the context of his analysis? For this you are getting 2 marks. Number C. Answer the following questions briefly in your own words. For this you are getting 8 marks. Here you need to write the summary of the passage. In not more than 60 words, describe the amazing qualities of Gandhiji as mentioned in the passage. You must maintain the word limit, because if you cross the word limit, the examiner can deduct your marks. So be careful about the word limit and write about the amazing qualities of Gandhiji as mentioned in the given passage. Question number 5. This question about fill in the blanks with proper form of verbs. In the following passage, fill in each of the numbered blanks with the correct form of the word given in brackets. Do not copy the passage, but write in correct serial order the word or phrase appropriate to the blank space. For this, you are getting 4 marks. So you need not to copy the passage. You just write the question number like 1, 2 as it is, and then with an underline, you will just write your answers. The passage is, he was dash regarded as the dash great musician of Indian cinema. There were days when he had dash sleep in the footpaths. He is an example that if you have talent and are truly dash hard work, you are bound to dash success. he was interested in music since a very young age. He got better with proper dash train. In his dash initiate days, he struggled a lot, but he dash say in an interview that is what made him what he is today. So students, you can write your answer in the comment box below, and you can join our group as well for checking your answers as well. Question number 5b. Fill in each blank with an appropriate word. This appropriate word specially refers to the preposition. Here you will get 8 blanks, and for this you will get 4 marks. That means each of these blank is containing 0.5 marks each. You need not to copy the questions. You will just write the question number after with an underline. You will write your answer in the way like this. Number 1. Adversity brings dash the good qualities of man. Number 2. It is dash my dignity to talk to him. Number 3. In the race he ran dash me. Number 4. Ankita will come here latest dash 7 PM. Number 5. He made an apology dash his misconduct. Number 6. Don't look down dash the poor. Number 7. The government is now taking dash the sick industries. Number 8. Are you confident dash your project? So here are 8 blanks, and you can write these answers in the comment box below, and you can join our group as well. Question number 5c. Join the following sentences to make one complete sentence without using and, but, or so. That means here 2 or more sentences will be given. You just need to make one complete sentence without using this word, such as and, but, or, and so. For these 4 questions, you will get 4 marks. So let's begin. Question number 1. He was tired of walking. He sat down to rest under a tree. Number 2. He will be granted justice. I have faith. Number 3. Go quickly. You will else be late. Number 4. She was ill. She attended the school. So I think all of you are preparing well. If you are confident about your preparation, then write the answers of the given questions in the comment box, and our faculty will give you the correct answer. Question number 5D. This is the last section of your question paper. Rewrite the following sentences according to the instructions given after each. Make other changes that may be necessary, but do not change the meaning of the sentence. That means here you will get 8 questions, and for the 8 questions you will get 8 marks. You can make certain changes which are necessary, but you can never change the meaning of the sentence. So let's begin the question. Question number 1. As soon as I rang the bell, the man came. Begin with no sooner. Question number 2. It is never too late to mend. Begin with it is not so. Number 3. Though he is poor, he is content. Begin with in spite of. Number 4. He is not the best boy in the class. Begin with very few. Number 5. They proposed to hold a meeting. Begin with it was. Number 6. Can I see the manager? I said. Rewrite using indirect speech. Number 7. I have not seen him for 7 years. Use since. Number 8. I was quite well so long as I stayed at Puri. Begin with during my. So here there are 8 questions, and the instructions are given within bracket. Here you need to be careful about practicing some phrases using no sooner, had, or as soon as, and voice change, one voice change, and one direct indirect speech. This is compulsorily given in your question paper, so practice this very carefully. You can write these answers in the comment box, and our faculty will check your answer. So prepare well. I bless all of you. God bless to you, and all the best for your exam. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from ICSE and WBSE English Solution, ICSE and ISC Computer Application with BlueJay. Thanks for watching.